A top Muslim scholar releases an edict denouncing terrorists as suicide bombers.
Leading Muslim scholars has issued.
It's not something you often hear from a leading Muslim scholar. A fatwa, a religious declaration that unequivocally states terrorism and suicide bombings are the biggest enemies of Islam.
Tahir al-Quadri is a respected Muslim scholar who's written 350 books.
I would say it is clear according to Quran and Sunnah, these kind of people having this terroristic or militant agenda has no link with Islamic teachings. So all these suicide, who are the targets? Targets are the human beings. So irrespective of anything, unexceptionally act of terrorism is terrorism. It cannot be allowed in any pretext. There's fatwa of Imam Abu Hanifa. I have given fatwa Imam Malik, fatwa Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, Imam Sufyan Sauri, Imam Mawardi, Imam Sarakhsi, Imam Kasani, Marghinani, Imam Ibn Qudama about kufr, Imam Nawawi, and Imam Ibrahim bin Mufli al-Hanbali and those. And finally, the latest Salafi ulama, Sheikh Abdul Aziz bin Baagh, Allama Nasiruddin Albani, and Ibn al-Fawzan, they declared that these 2 days terrorists are the Khawarij. Not a single person, maybe Osama or anybody else, maybe leader of any Al-Qaeda or any Taliban or anybody else, not a single person, not a group of individuals, not an organization, according to the classical teachings of Quran and Sunnah, has an authority to declare its activities as jihad.
Observers say this is the strongest criticism ever delivered by an Islamic leader.
And we are in fact taking Islam back from the terrorists.
Are you afraid for your own life?
I'm not afraid of any human being on the surface of earth. One have to live for truth and to die for truth.
I covered the war in Afghanistan in the 1980s and later, of course, the war in Bosnia. And in both cases, Muslims felt a duty to help their brothers and sisters in distress. I think everyone here will know the hadith, of course, about one body, when part of the body is ill, the whole body feels ill. At that time, and I remember coming up to Coventry, there were people raising money for cutting costs for the people in Bosnia who were suffering. And it was seen as a very proud thing to do, a very proper thing to do. Obviously, to do that now would be considered even an act of terrorism, where there are foreign armies occupying Darul Islam now, or at least their presence there. How do you see the two and compare the two in terms of the duty of Muslims to help their brothers?
Thank you. I understand and agree with you that the whole of the Muslim Ummah works like a body. But there are different organs of the body. Working as a body, no doubt about that, is what is required by Islam. And it has been practicing in the past. But at the same time, if a single organ of a body becomes cancerous, then other organs are not supposed to support this cancer. Then the other organs will always support the surgeon to cut this arm away so that the whole body is protected from spreading of cancer. And those people who are the criminal and terrorist, they have no religion. They have no attachment to any culture. They have no faith. They are faithless people. They are enemies of humanity as well as they are enemies of Islam. I am advising you to stop your activities here, change your way and try to please him. Every other thing which takes you away from the prayer of God will take you to the hell and hellfire. This life of 20 years, 30 years, 40, 50, 60 years is nothing. Think about the longest life, which is an endless life, which is never going to end. What will happen for that life?
I found it very emotional and overwhelming, very beautiful, and I didn't expect to get involved that much.
Basically, it's just been absolutely amazing. I've been overwhelmed by speeches and the actual atmosphere of the whole environment.
Are you ready to love Almighty Allah? Are you ready to love my beloved Prophet? Are you ready to love the beauty of Holy Prophet? Are you ready to love the vision of the beauty of the face of Mustafa? Are you ready for that? Put your hands here on your hearts. Close your eyes and say in your hearts, Almighty Allah, we repent. Forgive our sins.
The camp has been, alhamdulillah, an amazing experience. I think it's something that every kind of human being needs at certain times of their life, that they become, that their soul always needs to be recharged, or you could say their battery always needs to be recharged. And I think this moment and this time that we have is the best chance to do that, being under the guidance of Sheikh al-Islam.
It's been amazing. I mean, it's very spiritual being in the company of Sheikh al-Islam, Dr. Tahir al-Qadri, and I have gained a lot spiritually from the Sheikh and everything that, you know, the discourses he's given us, Sahih al-Bukhari.
Leave the love of Akhirah and be just for Allah, and be the slaves of Holy Prophet, and be slaves of Almighty Allah and His worshipper. These are good days, my dear sons and daughters. The young life is the best period of your life for changing. I want to see Noor on your faces. When everybody is sleeping, then get up. When everybody sleeps, go to his bed, then you go to your beloved Allah. My dear sons and daughters, don't lose this time, this ni'mah.
I've learned how to actually attain a relationship with Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
I mean, I would just say that you're being given the opportunity of spending your time in the company of the greatest Sheikh at this time on this earth, and don't miss it. Grab this opportunity with both your hands. As Sheikh Asad As-Sagharji said in one of his lectures, he said that with Sheikh al-Islam, Dr. Tahir al-Qadri, he is one of the greatest Sheikhs, and be greedy when you are coming towards him, because grab him with both hands and don't let him go. مفصل محكم لآل